for this particular amp pattern I'll be tying today is going to be on a D102 barbless hook made by Allen Fly Fishing between the sizes of 12 and 16. This hook has a great black finish to it. It's a standard length shank with a wide gape and an extremely sharp point to the hook. Check them out at www.allenflyfishing.com. Let's go ahead and begin by attaching our thread at the index point and advancing our thread back halfway down the shank of the hook and clipping the excess thread. Now advance your thread back about a quarter way down the bend of the hook and go ahead and create a pronounced thread base right at the bend of the hook. This will help assist in creating the butt end of the ant. Now go ahead and grab a small amount of superfine or microfine red quill dubbing and apply it to your thread. Now go ahead and take your dubbing and advance it around the thread, creating a tapered but pronounced butt, ending at the 50% point of the hook shank. Now go ahead and prepare an appropriate size piece of brown rooster cape hackle. To make sure it's the right size, go ahead and wrap it around the hook shank. The ends of the barbules of the feathers should extend slightly past the point of the hook. With the webby fibers pulled off the quill and the inside of the feather facing the inside of the hook shank, go ahead and attach it at the 50% point of the hook shank with secure thread wraps. Clip off the excess quill at the tie-down point. Now go ahead and apply a small amount of red quill dubbing and continue to create a tapered body from the 50% point of the hook shank to about the 70% point of the hook shank. Now with a pair of hackle pliers, go ahead and grab the hackle and begin to wrap it around the hook shank, beginning at the 50% point and ending at the 70% point. Make sure that each wrap of each hackle, the quill lays next to the previous one. Now go ahead and secure the hackle to the near side of the hook shank with secure thread wraps and clip off the excess quill as close as you can to the tie-down point. Now with your material hand, go ahead and pull back the feathers and create a small thread base back to the 60% point of the hook shank and clip off any excess hackle fibers extending past the tie down point. Now go ahead and apply some red quill dubbing to your thread. Now go ahead and create the head of the ant, beginning at the 60% point of the hook shank and ending at the 90% point of the hook shank. The head should continue to have a slight taper, and the diameter of the head should be about half the size as the butt end of the ant. Now go ahead and secure your thread just behind the eye using a whip finish tool and clip the excess thread. Now with this pair of scissors, go ahead and cut off any excess dubbing around the butt end and the head of the ant, ensuring that it has a nice, smooth taper. And that's how you tie the Cinnamon Toast ant.